Okay, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, you guys have probably seen the journey on this channel as far as my progress with learning German and whatnot. And I wanted to talk about like how it's actually changed my entire life. I've never been to Germany. I never really had the need to learn German my entire life. But as I did YouTube and whatnot, I stumbled across this niche and I'm like, you know what? I'll stick with it, you know? And I made a commitment last year, the beginning of last year, to actually take learning German a lot more serious, you know? But I didn't want to do it in a way that put too much pressure on myself, you know? I kind of like put a lot of pressure on myself anyways to learn German as fast as humanly possible, at least the understanding aspects and whatnot, not necessarily the speaking aspects. So this video, I'm gonna be telling you guys basically all the ways I can think of that learning German has literally changed my entire life. And it's incredible. And the purpose of this video is to kind of inspire other people who wanna learn either German or a new language and kind of like really understand those lasting effects, because it's so crazy. Every time I think I haven't made any progress, or even when I take little breaks here and there, I always think that I'm starting from ground zero. But then I'll go back into a lesson and I'm like, ooh, I didn't realize I knew so much, you know? So number one, I think, is I am able to communicate and understand other people that speak German. Now, to elaborate, right? I am not a professional. I've only been speaking German for a year and a half. And there's a huge improvement between the beginning and now, but there is also not as much improvement as I feel like a typical person who's been, you know, speaking it for a year and a half, like, should be having, because I've been a casual learner, so to speak. So there were months where I was practicing every single day. I was doing lessons. I was talking to people. I was learning new words. Very, very, very adamant. As of late, I'd say over the last 3 or 4 months, it's been very on and off. The only thing that's been consistent is me uploading German related content on my channel. And, you know, I'll make videos, and that's why, you know, I post videos every day. So I'm like, all right, cool. That's been keeping me on track. So even if I'm not working on my speaking, I'm definitely working on my understanding, and it helps a lot. You know, it's been keeping me kind of afloat for the last 4 months, but I can say that I can finally understand people and stuff like that. So it's easy to communicate. And with that being a thing, I can make friends now that speak German. In fact, there are a lot of new friends I've made in person and even over Discord talking to you guys. And I don't think it would be a thing if I did not learn any German. In fact, it's crazy too, because there's people from Germany that want to talk with me. And I don't think those conversations could have been had I not taken the initiative to learn the language, because sometimes their English isn't that good, you know? And my German's not the best, but I think it's understandable at this point. So at least everyone will understand what I'm trying to say. And they're like, oh, okay. And it makes having a conversation easier. So that's kind of the first little thing. The second thing kind of piggybacks off the first thing, but it's not necessarily for making friend purposes, but because I understand a lot more German, I'm able to watch YouTube videos now without subtitles. I mean, yeah, I used to use the for those that followed me since like maybe the middle of 2019, I used to use subtitles a lot when I would watch, like, you know, German related videos, minus the Deutsch reactions, or like the Deutsch rap reactions, because I mean, I didn't really care to know what people were saying, to be honest. But I don't have to watch, like, you know, standard videos from German YouTubers in, you know, English and stuff like that. Like, I don't have to turn the English auto-generated subtitles on. Number one, because they're horrible when it comes to translating German to English. And number two, it's because I genuinely understand most of what's being said. Now, I emphasize the most part, because a lot of times there are brand new words I'm learning every day, even still, that I just don't know. And I guess as I watch more YouTubers and things of that nature, I'm learning more and more and more. I'm getting back into the swing of things of learning more German and stuff like that now. So that's been a thing. Like I said, I learn a little something every day. I speak a little bit every day, even if though it's not a lot. And like I said, I'm definitely, my progress is not as good as I would like it to be. I need to put in more work. You know, you know what they say, you get in what you put in. But what I can say is I think it's remarkable, because I feel like now when, like, you know, if my friends and I ever hang out, you know, and like, I'm like, oh, yo, look at this clip. This is so funny. And I play like a clip of like a German, like, you know, Deutsch meme compilation or whatever. They're like, I don't understand anything. And I'm like, I actually do. Like, that's kind of crazy, but not everything, not everything. I want to emphasize the not everything part, because I feel like now I still understand like maybe 70% of what's being said to me, or just what's being said in general. So that's kind of like, it's a big deal though, because I feel like it also allows me to understand context. I think the third way, I guess, learning German has changed my life is it's allowed me to feel more confident to travel to Germany, if that makes sense. I want to elaborate on that one a little bit, because I've seen a lot of expat videos. You guys know we do a lot of expat video reactions on this channel. And one of the biggest tips a lot of them have is trying to at least understand the basics when it comes to learning German and stuff like that. So you know how to maneuver, you know how to get around. You're not really struggling when you actually wind up entering, like, you know, let's say rural areas and not a lot of people speak good English. So that's been huge, absolutely huge. Because I think now I feel very confident. I've been asking you guys for validation and stuff like that. I've been speaking with you guys in Discord. I've been listening to you guys in Discord whenever you guys are in the Discord chats and stuff. And it really, really warms my soul to know that at this point I'm very understandable. I can actually start communicating my thoughts in German. I don't have a whole lot of videos speaking completely German, because you know, I still have a low self-esteem when it comes to how good my German is, but I can at least say that it is understandable for people, and I think I can definitely move around the country flawlessly. I need to, you know, make sure that I'm speaking a lot more often, because I definitely haven't been speaking it very regularly, but I do feel comfortable speaking when I do speak, if that makes sense. So that's another thing. I think that was number three. I'm going to move on to number four. But number four is a little weird, because it's an aspect I don't think that a lot of people would even really consider looking at from this angle. But it's actually like forced me to have somewhat of a routine, you know, and it's allowed me to kind of look at both the good and the bad aspects of my life in general, because how I view my progress with German and how I treat my progress with German is how I pretty much treat my progress and my thoughts with anything else. You know, when I'm trying to learn something, when I'm trying to devote myself to getting better at something, sometimes I do reach a burnout point and I still want to get better anyways, but I'll intentionally back off a little bit so I don't burn out, right? I give myself some breathing room and I allow myself to kind of like, you know, recoup and then come back. Now, what does that mean, right? So sometimes, like, I remember there'd be periods of time where I'd come home, I would spend like 5 or 6 hours a day studying German and stuff like that. And I would use that same energy, you know, in the past for like the gym or drawing or, you know, just making a bunch of YouTube videos in general. And I noticed that whenever I reach a point where I'm almost burnt out, especially like, let's say with YouTube, because I talk about YouTube all the time, I'll batch record, right? So like on Saturdays, I'll record like 40 or 50 videos. I'll upload them all to YouTube. I'll private them and then I'll unprivate them throughout the week. So it gives me some days to recover and stuff and think of some, like, you know, new ideas that are not necessarily just reactions or commentary and stuff like that, that you guys might actually like, you know, to tap into, like, oh my god, like, this is a cool video, I might as well check this out. So yeah, it allows me to like kind of like reflect on my life in a way where I'm like, oh, okay, cool, like I'm tracking and stuff, and I can and like the good and bad aspects of my life are kind of exposed, because I'm like, dang, like I have my lazy days and I'm like, damn, like I feel like I'm not making any progress, and I'm like, I'm not making any progress because I'm not putting in the work, you know. And then there's other days where I feel great, like I told you guys a month and a half ago I got in trouble at work and I felt horrible, and one of the only things that made me feel good was going back to the basics of just learning more German. It put me in a really good mood, like, because even if I did not understand everything, I was learning something. I was learning a new word, I was learning a new sentence structure, you know, I was learning how to pronounce things better, maybe in a different dialect. I was learning about different dialects. I was learning, you know, about different aspects of how the system in Germany is set up. That to me was a win, because I'm like, I'm very interested in that. And if I can learn something new, that's always a win. The biggest thing too, I think the number five and probably the biggest aspect learning German has changed my life is I'm able to share the wealth with other people that are interested in learning German. I have friends now who want to learn German simply because they've seen me do this for a long time. They're like, why is he doing German content on his channel? That makes zero sense. What, bro? I understand. It looks weird. People are probably like, what the heck? I literally had a couple friends. One of my friends like, yo, I'm getting into learning German and stuff. Like, do you have any tips? Like, how did you learn it so fast? How do you understand it so good? And in my head, I'm like, I don't understand it that good. And I definitely don't speak it that well. And I don't think I learned it that fast. But I guess a year is pretty quick to kind of pick up on something, right? So I gave him some tips and stuff. And like, my tip to anybody watching this at this point, Babbel, Duolingo, and Discord. Those are your three apps that they will never fail you, right? Babbel is going to cost some money. But it's worth it and stuff. I can confirm it is definitely worth it. It'll teach you the sentence structure, why the sentences are structured the way they are. It'll teach you new words and stuff like that. It'll give you quizzes to kind of make sure that you're being reevaluated on your knowledge of the language and stuff. Duolingo is more all over the place. So if you learn through Duolingo, yes, you'll learn new words, but you won't necessarily learn new sentence structure. I feel like there's already a preconceived like set of knowledge that you kind of need for Duolingo to an extent to really thrive on that app. And after you're done, you know, downloading both of those, I definitely would recommend hopping in a Discord server that has a lot of German people in it or people trying to learn German, because you'll accelerate really quickly, like speaking it all the time and having conversations. I think that's huge. I'm going to start spinning back up the series of me speaking with you guys in Discord, because I know you guys like that. I know it helped me out, and you know, it makes good daily content. I feel like, even though sometimes we might not be talking about anything, I'm just improving my German. So I guess that to me it's huge, because now, like, you know, people that are close to me that look up to me are trying to learn German. And I think that's huge. It's inspirational, because it's like, oh, okay, like a lot of people say, you know, Deutsche Sprache, schwere Sprache, and they are like, oh yeah, like German is impossible. You know, I don't want to learn German. I was like that too. Don't get me wrong. I was definitely like that. But after continuously attacking, and like challenging myself every day to learn, to understand, to process, I feel like my persistence has kind of inspired other people to try to learn that too, at least people around me that I actually know. I don't know about other people who I don't know, but yeah, that's pretty much it. Those are the ways that I feel like Germany's changed my life and whatnot. I am gonna make a video on my plans to Germany again. I think I've made like 7 videos on that, but they keep changing due to the pandemic and like my situation in the military, so we'll talk more about that later. But let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. How do you think my progress has been? If I'm being honest with myself, I feel like my progress was really great in the beginning, and then it slowed down a bit, and now I'm at the point where it's like slow. It's like molasses, but we're still moving along. We're keeping it pushing, but it is very slow. So I'm not going to beat myself up over that. I have beaten myself up quite a bit over how bad my German is. What I can say is my speaking, my Aussprache is it's okay certain days, and certain days it's not. So I feel like that just comes with speaking it a lot more often. My last question to you guys is, would you be willing to join the Discord server? It is linked in the description down below to speak with me. I know I haven't been super, super active in Discord, but I'm going to try. That would be huge in helping me get better. But I would love to speak with you guys. Seriously, it would really help, and it would mean the world. And I think it'll open up an entire world of other content we can do in the future, the better I speak and the better I understand. That's pretty much it. I love you guys. Thank you guys so much for listening to me rant in another video again. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And this is mainly for my regular viewers, so I'm pretty sure this isn't going to get pushed out or anything. That's fine. I love you guys so much. Take care.
Well, 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 what a pleasure it is to see all of your beautiful faces at the end of this lovely video.
Subscribe if you haven't already.
I'm sure you know, as I've mentioned in the past, we do have a Discord that's linked in the description down below, and we would love to have you a part of the world's greatest community ever, Bray Gang. Yes, if you've made it to this point in the video, you're officially a part of the community. So go ahead, join the Discord server. Link is in the description down below. And we also have other social media as well, like Instagram, Twitter. We're live. We go live on Twitch quite often as well. So it would behoove you to, you know, go ahead and subscribe to the Twitch channel at twitch.tv/JamesBrayGang. Join the cause and be a part of the greatest, literally the greatest community ever. Okay, it's simple. Just go ahead and do those little things. We're trying to grow on all these little platforms and everything, and it really means a lot. Now, I know you guys stumbled up across the channel and you're like, what does this guy post? Like, what kind of content does he post? Reactions, vlogs, pretty much whatever comes to my mind. All right, it's random content. I don't know what I'm gonna be posting 10 years from now, but I do know that you can stick along for the journey, and it really means a lot. Now, for every single person that subscribes and follows all of the accounts that I have made, and all the links will be in the description down below, that's an automatic entry for any future giveaways I decide to have. I'll remind you when the giveaways take place, but you'll be surprised what I will be giving away because you guys have supported me so much up to this point, and it's only right that I do the same thing back. Thank you guys so much for being amazing, and I will see you in the next video. Take care. Peace.